The goaltenders are front and center in this one. And this was the final play before the icing. And Clifford goes in. Howard's had enough. Richard challenges Howard afterwards right here. Glendening comes in. And then they all convene. And then when we went to commercial, look at what happened through center ice. Quick and Howard, who are both going to be on Team USA at center ice. And they're not exchanging Christmas gifts either. Look at this. Oh, boy. And there are two linesmen. Look at Quincy laughing his butt off over there saying, what are you doing over there? Two goaltenders, two linesmen, a referee O'Halloran saying, all right, boys. Children will be children.
Big period for Chicago. Comes right to the line. Time for a shot. Doesn't get through. On the horn. Ending the period. And they rush the net pretty well. Draws the crowd with a goalie getting bumped in there.
Yeah, Shaw's in there again. Yep. And Quick is upset. And now his teammates are as well.
Jonathan Quick has been is pulling at the skates of somebody in the pile, as he's not happy. And you know Crawford took the hit earlier in the game, and that didn't make the Blackhawks very happy at all. So they've made Jonathan look at Crawford
here. Now they're gonna
I don't think Crawford's pleased. He was pulling at the skates of somebody.
And he wants to go.
Yeah.
I think he'd better go to the bench and get to the room. That's where he's got to go.
You're right, Bob.
Chicago is leading the hockey game. A big, big hockey game. Trying to get it to seven games in this series.
Well, we're going to have a look at what started all this.
Shots in the period were even. Ooh. 13 apiece.
Little chat afterward there. I want to go, says Crawford. Where's he getting the energy, Bob?
Well, Crawford and Quick just butted heads away from the blue line. Quick was going off the ice, and Crawford stood in his way. Quick came right up to him, and they literally bumped foreheads. I don't know if I've seen that in a long time. Quick was in a bad mood leaving the crease. Now watch this exchange. Has a couple of words for Crawford. Crawford was jawing at him. Oh, that's great stuff.
Oh, boy. Oh, now he wants to drop the gloves.
This may not be the time for the two goalies to fight.
Stay tuned. Some fireworks at the end of period two.
The goaltender confrontation. Watch Corey Crawford near the blue line there. Now watch when his body language changes. Crawford started it. It's like he's waiting for Quick. He's just watching the skirmish down by the net. Now here comes Quick. Now watch Crawford. Now look at him. Now he turns right to him. He started talking. Quick goes, what? What? They just bump right into each other. Classic stuff. The classic goaltender confrontation. Look at that. Even Crawford with a little shake of the hand there. Like, really? Are you going to drop him? I love this. What a great 20 we're going to have here.
To the side of the net where Bork takes a Pittsburgh player right into Fleury.
That's Bork going to take a penalty.
Orpik at the bottom of that pile, but it is getting chippy here in the late stages.
This goes back to Orpik finishing on Brennan Gallagher, and then here we go. Everybody.
Crosby trying to pull Crust away, which might get dangerous.
Peter Budaj coming out and take a look at Marc-Andre Fleury.
And Fleury
had a little exchange with each other.
Yeah, Fleury gave him a little shrug. If you want to come down, you're welcome.
Budaj getting pointed back into the net for Francois Saint-Laurent.
Yep. Flower still talking about 150 feet.
And Budaj's got his hands up. He's here to go.
There we go. Potential of one to just get everybody a little more excited.
Carey Price got to get back. He seems to do everything, but starts right here with Orpik getting run-ins on top of Marc-Andre Fleury. Pressful, that's a cross-check. And big melee stem from that. And then Marc-Andre Fleury says, okay, time to go. Leave me alone. That's Kyle Raymond breaking them up. Little how she goes, dancing around him. Rudai getting his jersey pulled up.
Looks like Peter's done this before.
Marc-Andre Fleury was undoing his tie-down so he could get out of his jersey. You see him there trying to undo it as he's skating around. As the ref and linesman would not let them get together.
Kyle Raymond and Francois Saint-Laurent, they want to see that tennis tonight too.
Now John Scott was over having a chat with the Leaf bench as we went to commercial break. And he's out on the ice right now.
Well, it was a, if there is such a thing, a fair fight. So nobody's going to get more now, penalty minutes than anyone else.
Here we go. Scott went after Kessel, and Kessel is given. Whoa, this has brought something on.
Yeah.
Kessel is now fighting with Brian Flynn. Goaltender Bernier is out there as well. My goodness. There are fights all over the ice. John Scott threw a punch at Kessel, and he took the stick to Scott. Now it's got everybody involved.
Well, the theory is that when you think that you have to do something to settle things down, don't go after the toughest guy on the ice. Go after somebody else.
Well, Kessel has stopped with Brian Flynn. Flynn is bleeding, I believe.
Wow. Well, when you take a look at this crowd and you hear somebody said they should take fighting out of hockey.
Bernier's going after Miller. Here they're going.
Bernier and Miller. Bernier and Miller now jostling along. The last time a Leaf goalie was involved in something like this was Felix Potvin. Miller and Bernier. Well, the backup goalies had better get ready. And Bernier throwing some punches.
I've never seen Miller in a fight before, and I've...
Well, he got run over a couple of times. Now Bernier's got an arm free without the big goalie pad on. And Miller's in a little trouble here.
Ooh. He's giving it to him.
A couple of right hands. The linesmen aren't breaking this up either.
Are you watching, Felix?
And Scott is over on the other side. And David Clarkson is there.
Look at Kessel now. He spears him. Kessel came back and speared Scott.
Well, he gave him a tap with the stick for sure. Wow.
Oh, be careful from the bench or you get suspended.
Well,
Ashton right in there. Give Ashton credit too.
Preseason game. Kessel has gone to the dressing room.
Scott's going too. We know that.
They need to get Scott off the ice here, or this is going to get escalated even more.
Yeah, I wonder how different things are with Colton Orr and Fraser McLaren in the Toronto lineup here for John Scott.
Well, there's a couple of Buffalo tough guys not in the lineup too.
True enough.
Give the guys credit, you know, they went right after Scott, after Kessel and him were jabbing each other at the faceoff dot.
Well, this will be interesting when to hand the penalties out. They just send everybody who fights with 9:59 to go, you're all gone.
Oh, God.
Never mind the penalties, wait till the suspensions arrive tomorrow. Because there will be suspensions from this.
Yes, there will.
There'll be a lot of room on the bench when this is all cleared up. But all five players, all six players on the ice, including the goaltenders, are going to be it.
You know, give Kessel credit, too. I mean, he has not backed down in this exhibition. He's been challenged a couple of times. And here it is, Scott. He'll talk to Kessel. They don't like what happened to the fight, and then Scott just goes after him. But look at the guys here. Ashton gets right in, and then Kessel gets a couple of licks in.
You're coming after me. You're going to eat a lot of stick.
They call that team toughness. Nashton in there, and then the goalies go at it. And Bernier does really well. Bernier just maybe 6 foot at best, going against a much taller Ryan Miller. And Bernier, I got to give him the decision.
And Ryan Miller, who's had concussion issues.
Look at those babies.
Another way to get one.
Look what happens when you cut down the size of the goalie equipment.
Wow.
Well, I'll never forget.
Bernier gets that right in, free arm. Oh,
I'll never forget the fight between Hextall and Potvin. I thought Felix was going to get murdered, and he went down there and showed us all that he was a pretty good fighter.
Well, I have to admit, when I saw that matchup, I was a little wondering how that was going to look too. I don't know. Like, I mean, he's got to protect himself too. I mean, he got jumped there.
There's one.
So and then look at the guys, Ashley
there's
right
two.
In there, Bozak right in there, and then Kessel ends up winning his fight too afterwards.
Well, something that I bet he's not had to do in a National Hockey League uniform.
Oh, but he.
I don't think either one of these guys have ever fought before.
Kessel won this one for sure.
Ooh. Not unless you had a brother. And watch the top of the frame here. And there's David Clarkson coming off the bench.
Oh, boy. And the ref looked right at him when he did.
That's a foolish
NHL game. The guy was signed to a pretty hefty contract, and now we've got warming, or I should say, another cavalting run at by Simmons, and Simmons will drop the gloves of Tom Wilson, who can really throw them. And now Ray Emery's racing the length of the ice. Ray Emery is challenging Holtby. Holtby's saying, no, I don't think I want to go. And the referee's going to try to keep them separated, and he won't be able to do that as away they go. Emery with the right hand's free, and he's hammering away on Holtby. Capitals not coming to his aid at this point as Emery is just having his way with Holtby.
Well, this has been going on. There's been a lot of talk going back and forth, and anything but friendly.
Oh,
and this is
another one going now as LeCavalier is trading with Alexi, and now Shen going at it as well with Urbom, and it's a line brawl for sure here at Wells Fargo Center. Just about everybody tangled up right here. Shen goes down as Urbom winds up on top of that scuffle. A lot of frustration.
This is frustration.
Like
absolutely, Jimmy. And you know what? This is a calling card. This is saying, okay, guys, all right, we're getting waxed right now in the score. But, hey, don't leave anything on the ice. Go home and they'll understand that you're going to come back tomorrow with a little fire. This is the fire that the Flyers have been looking for.
Ray Emery knew exactly what he wanted to do. And John Carlson's losing his mind now because he doesn't think the referee helped Holtby enough, as the ref was there trying to stop the fight, but just one referee there and two bodies. And Ray Emery put a beating on Braden Holtby, who heads over to the athletic trainer of the Capitals, and the referees talk as they try to sort this out.
Oh, they're going to have a tough time with this one. It all started with Simmons and Wilson, because Wilson had been really gabby with the Washington Capitals, been going at it with Hartnell all night to my left. And then all of a sudden, Simmons knew, because Simmons had been pretty aggressive too throughout this evening as far as the narration. Let's go once again and take a look how this all started.
Well, Wayne Simmons was aggressive. Make his first target right there as he ran over Alexi, and then he went after Wilson. Wilson quickly dropping the gloves, and Simmons really held his own against a guy who's known as quite a fighter, Tom Wilson. And while this is happening, Emery is making a dash for Holtby, who wanted nothing to do with him at first. And then finally they go as one referee, not enough, as Francois Saint-Laurent just could not keep them apart.
Yeah, and Emery just kept going and kept throwing punches. And Holtby tried to get up and react, and then two more fights broke out. While that was going on, Braden Shen dropped his gloves. with Urban. Knocked the helmet off first, and a couple of rights going back and forth between those two guys. And Vinny LeCavier at the same time fighting Oleski, who's a real tough kid. And Vinny held his own in that department.
Well, every one of those were good ones. But Emery, remember when Emery first was a draft pick of the Ottawa Senators, he had come up. Everybody knew that one thing he could do on top of playing net was he could really throw them. Any questions here? Right here, you can tell.
He's had some boxing training, and, you know, hope he is trying to protect himself in any way he can.
It was the fight when he was with Ottawa against the Buffalo Sabres. Was it Marty Biron that he ended up fighting in that game?
It was. He
and the heavyweight Peters. Also, he fought the heavyweight of the Buffalo Sabres that night.
Peters got involved, yeah. There are the penalties.
I was not great in math, so I'm going to have troubles with that one.
Well,
Coatsy, it's all yours. Figure that out for us.
Well, just go right down the side. You obviously, Simmons and Wilson are going to go. You got Shen and Urban. LeCavier, Oleski. I would imagine everybody will just get 5-10 get thrown right out of here. Let's see who's in the box over there. We got Simmons still in the box.
Well, we can see right there Wilson's in the box.
Emery will get leaving the crease as you see Steve Mason back.
Right. Simmons is gone now. Emery's gone. Mason back in.
And right now, Saint-Laurent telling Claude Giroux about the penalties. Who knows, and will tell the rest of us momentarily. It may take him a while.
Yep. Holtby appears to be fine. He'll stay in goal.
Flyers number 40, Vincent Cavalier, 5 minutes for fighting, plus a game is timed up each for secondary fight. Washington penalty number 34, Alexander Urban. Flyers penalty number 10, Braden Shen. Each 5 minutes are fighting. Each game misconduct, secondary fight. Number 24, Washington. Aaron Volpatti, a 10-minute misconduct. For Washington, number 70, Braden Holtby, goalkeeper. 5 minutes are fighting. For the Flyers, number 29, goalkeeper Ray Emery. 2 minutes for leaving the crease. 2 minutes for instigation. 5 minutes are fighting. A 10-minute misconduct plus a game misconduct. Penalties come in 5 minutes,
there you go.
31 seconds.
And the two minors on Emery, the only difference in the penalty calls, in addition to, of course, his misconduct, but as far as affecting manpower, it's a 4-minute power play for the Capitals as they get back to action. And the league will look at that situation as well.
They will.
No question about it, they'll review that. Just make sure everything was okay with it. Emery did leave his crease. There's no question what he was trying to do there. Here's Raffle cutting it on goal. The backhander and the save made by Holtby.
Well, it was a nice shot. He had nowhere to go. He was stuck right there on the backhand because Green was on the other side of him. He was looking upstairs, but just didn't get enough on it.
You got to give Holtby some credit because he just got pounded in a fight.
Yeah.
Gets right back in there, faces a partial breakaway, and takes care of him.
Yep, good concentration on his part. You have to like what Ray Emery did there to try to get something from his teammates in front of him.
Well, as we mentioned, Steve Mason now back in the game, having a little trouble handling the puck there. Craig Berube tried everything he could to get this thing turned around. Ray Emery figuring out the best thing I can do at this point. And he took off. Carlson down low. The shot up high. Mason the save. So he was able to get that one. Now Carlson from the point. That one snared by Emery. He'll hang on to it. It was Schmidt down low that first opportunity. But Mason made the save.
You can reserve a suite for an upcoming Flyers game through November and choose a free suite to the return of Disney on ice this holiday season or from one of two Phantoms games this February. Lock your Wells Fargo Center suites in now.
Well, Simmons, you could tell, was right on a mission, wasn't he? Right off that face-off, bang. Then he ends up with Wilson, who happens to be a little bit bigger at 6'4". Did a heck of a job with him, and Emery just jumped right on the opportunity and skated the 200 feet.
Yeah, we should point out Simmons had the same tactics. Rammer, he was trying to do something there. Just frustration, yes. That puck deflects into the blue paint and Mason covers, but clearly just tried to say, boys, we can't just take this one without showing some kind of fight.
Yep.
And so he ended up in a fight with a guy who can really drop the gloves and go in Tom Wilson, and Simmons did win that fight. There's Backstrom.